So what I've done so far is I've taped off the bottom part, the foreground of my canvas, and I used a plastic lid and made a circle. That's going to be our moon. And we're going to paint in the background in a blue-black. I'm going to use Prussian blue, but you can use your phthalo or your ultramarine blue, or, you know, whatever blue that you have, but kind of a dark color. And you won't need a whole lot of black, just a little bit to darken it up a little bit more than it normally is. And I'm not going to use a very large brush because it's not a very large canvas. It's just a 9x12. And paint it in. Try to go around my moon and keep it circular. So I'm going to go slow here. And you got to forgive me if I'm talking funny. Just last week I had some oral surgery done. And my whole face is swollen and bruised, and so, I mean, it even hurts to smile. But I'm like, just, so I'm getting some time off from the homeschool, and I seem to have a tough time finding time to paint, and I thought, why not now? Okay, so paint in the background. So how's everybody been? I haven't, I've been so busy between school and my button making, I haven't had time to do much of anything. On Saturday, I watched a few of the painting videos. Cinnamon's got an awesome steampunk girl that I want to try, and Jane did a finger painting, a floral finger painting, and I gave that a try. That was fun. No brushes, all with my fingers. Turned out pretty good. I did it different than she did. I used different colors and did a different vase shape. But I did have fun doing that. That was really fun. Definitely, if you're scared of getting messy, you wouldn't want to do that one. So what we're doing is we're painting a night sky. We're going to have this glowing moon and a brick wall on the bottom. And then we're going to have several kitty cats sitting on top of the brick wall, just doing a little bit of moon gazing. and we'll see if we need to fill any in. I'm going to do my edges while I've got the paint out, because I don't want to have to buy a frame. If it turns out nice, I would like to hang it. All these paintings, it's like I don't have enough wall for, so I can't keep using this big giant canvas. It's gotta smull it down some. And the ones that I really like get very prominent spaces, you know, like in the dining room or in the living room. I'm just doing the edges here. I'm not going to remove my tape yet because I want to see if I have to, cover up any white that might be poking through, which really probably won't matter too much because, you know, we got to splatter some stars into the sky. So, take a break, let that dry. Now I'm taking titanium white and just a teeny, 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 like a speck on the tip of your brush, and mixing it in with the white to give just a slight yellow tint to do the background of the moon. And I might even want a little bit more yellow than that. So I want it to really kind of like it's glowing. This brush is an angle brush that I've used a whole lot, and it has gotten very fluffy. So if you're trying to be very delicate with your edges, this fluffy brush is not the brush to use. Background's not dry yet, but I'm going to go ahead and remove my tape. Got a nice straight line of that. Okay, removed my tape. And if you were wondering why that tape looks so pretty, it's because it was some washi tape. I could not find my artist tape or painter's tape. Now I'm looking for, I thought I pulled everything out, but I do not see it. I am looking for my burnt umber. I know it's, I've used most of it. And this is what happens when you don't get to paint very often. You don't know where your stuff is at. Got it. Let's see if I can get the lid off. Oh, got it. Okay, so the base layer of our brick wall is going to be burnt umber or whatever dark brown you might have available. That is totally up to you. For keeping that line straight. All right, when it dries, we'll just go over it with some more blue. Thank you. now we really have to let this dry to be able to go on. So I'm going to take a break, see who was just trying to get a hold of me, and let this dry. You can use your blow dryer to speed it up, and I will be back. Plus, I need some clean water already. All right, so I got a little bit impatient and got out the old blow dryer and gave it a little zap with that. Okay, so we're going to work on our wall a little bit more. And I'm going to use... what size do I want? I guess this one's a good size. This one's a number 6. And I'm going to use burnt sienna. Or not burnt. Yeah, burnt sienna. And we're going to paint in some bricks. Now at this point, you could draw chalk lines if you really want to keep it straight. I'm not overly concerned about how straight my lines are. So we're going to paint in some bricks with our burnt sienna. Leaving a space in between so that your grout shows through. Now, if you want a lighter grout, don't use the burnt umber underneath. I did it dark because it's nighttime and in the shadows. But you could use, kind of like a grayish color, or even like the color we did with the moon there. And then you just come in and put in your little bricks. Just these little dashes, leaving space in between. So, and we're going to add a lot of color to this, so don't panic if you don't think that it's showing up enough for you. We're going to use some yellow and some white and some red, some green. Now when you do your next row, you're going to leave space in between, and you don't want them, you want to stagger them. You can see that. You know, start about halfway from one brick and go halfway to the other brick, leaving a line in between the rows, also in between the bricks. Sorry, I know I'm talking terribly, but it's way better than it was 3 days ago. I could barely move my mouth. So this part would be like probably the most time consuming. Then you're going to go down your next row and stagger it again. You know, about middle of the brick to the middle of the next brick, leaving the space in between the rows and in between the bricks. You don't have to worry. You know, they don't all have to be the same size. Unless you want them to be. Instead of a brick wall, you could also do this with a wooden fence, but I wanted a brick wall. On to my next row. Same thing, space in between the rows, spaces in between the bricks, staggering them so that your grout line shows through. Now, of course, if you were doing this on a bigger canvas, your everything would be bigger. Your moon would be bigger. Your bricks would be bigger. Okay. Next row. It looks like we're only going to have one more row after this one on mine. Course, depending on where you put your the top of your wall, will depend on how many rows and the size of the brush that you use to do these bricks with. Done with this, I'm going to switch to a smaller brush. When I start adding my colors to it, I don't want to cover up all of my burnt sienna until my canvas isn't completely square because it keeps wobbling on me. This was, I got a big pack of these 9x12 canvases for Christmas. That was one of my requests. I need canvases. Okay. So now I'm going to use some cad red medium. Smaller brush. This one looks good. And again, this is another one that I've used and abused, and it's pretty puffy nowadays. So I'm just going to come through and touch a little red here and there. Don't have to put it on every single brick, or you can, totally up to you. This process is going to be what makes it look bricky. going to use some yellow ochre. When you put these colors out on this small canvas, you don't need much at all. I'm going to have a lot of wasted paint here because I get squeeze happy. Okay. I'm going to use that same brush. Algae will grow on a brick wall. So we're going to use a little bit of sap green. Brushes to get that bead of water. Okay, and I'm going to kind of do it to the right and the bottom. One thing that's going to really help it, the bricks pop out, is giving it some white. Now, you want just a little bit, and it's going to be on the top of the brick, not on the bottom. It'd be like, if we had some light hitting this, it's going to hit the top part of the brick. And down the left, because we put the green down the right. So I got a little detail brush so I can control it a little better. And it's going to come across the top edges. Across the top of the wall here, it probably should go pretty much all the way across, even on the where the grout lines are. Not a solid line, but you know, kind of broken up. That's the top of the wall. Bricks, and then I'll come back and go down on the right of some of them. And it doesn't have to be, you know, perfectly straight, because, you know, when you see the red brick that's been laid, you know, there's different thicknesses and there might be little chunks missing out of the bricks. You know, so it gives it like a lot of texture. Here in silence, but then again, I don't want to talk your ear off either, especially right now. And plus, you know, when we get quiet, we're concentrating. So you could even take a dry brush and, like, if it didn't dry already on you, scratch a little of that white inward. So, I want a little bit more glow up here in my moon, and I'm going to use my stencil brush and tap in some plain white. Sometimes put a little silver in my moons. Where's my silver? I do not see my silver. So we'll use a little gold. It's time to let it dry again. Okay, so I'm going to use some titanium white. I'm going to be brave here. And a round detail brush and draw in the shapes of my cats. So we're going to have several cats, and basically I'm going to do like a really rounded heart shape, and I'm going to have this cat kind of tilting his head that way, give him a round head, bring his neck down. I'm gonna fill it in with the white because, you know, we gotta cover our dark colors with our other colors for the cats. And this will just help us help them show up a little better. Okay. So he's gonna have an ear that way. An ear that way. Then he's gonna have a tail. Combs and curls. And then next to him, there will be another cat. We're going to do our rounded heart shape. And it's okay if they overlap because they're sitting kind of close to each other. And let's have him tilting his head this way. This one will definitely be our Tom. He's big. And some ears. And a tail. We'll let his tail curve that same direction. Another cat here. Our rounded heart shape. He's a little bit harder to see because of the moon, but once we get some color into him, he'll be fine. And this one, you're going to whip his tail around that way. are kind of overlapping a little. And I think one more, you know, because odd is better. Letting that dry, and that's when we get to really have some fun, is we get to throw some whacked out colors on this and make it fun. We're going to put some stars in our sky. Now you can sit there, you can splatter if you want, but I don't want. So that's completely up to you. I'm going to touch with my brush, little detail brush, and go from there, because I just don't want a big mess. Of course, you know, splattering using a toothbrush or tapping will, you know, it'll look a lot more random and more natural. But I'm just not into the mess today. It's too much. Thank you. watery. Look at that. A lot less watery white on my brush. I'm going to turn this. And I'm going to go and make a plus sign. I'm going to get a finer brush. This one has like one hair. I don't know if you can see that. It has one little hair on it. I can make some tiny little off in the distance starbursts. Put as many of these as you want, but again, I think needs an odd number, so I'm gonna put one more. Real big one. And I think the plus sign should be bigger than the X. Break time again, and I think it's looking pretty good so far. I don't know, you guys got a big glare on that? It's hard to tell with the white. Okay, so let's let it sit, let it rest, and decide on what colors that we want to make our cats. Remember, we can get crazy here. They don't have to look like real cats. They're crazy little critters. Okay, so I set out a little bit of cat orange, cat red, a bright green, cat yellow, and a little bit of blue. And we're going to have some wild and crazy cats here. So let's do yellow cat on the end. Thank you. orange. And these colors are like real transparent. So, might take a couple of coats. Now, once we get our colors in, can't see us. Okay. What I was saying is, once we get our colors in, then we'll go back and put some designs on the cats, you know, maybe they have stripes, or maybe they're polka dotted, or maybe they're just all the same color, but, what do you call it, have darker ears, or the tail only has stripes, or whatever. Okay, I think I'm gonna put my blue cat in the middle. My paint seems like it's drying up a little. Not because it's been sitting out long, I just put it out, and I think just because it's starting to get old. What's that tell you? I don't get to paint enough. Green or red? red. Funny, you wouldn't think a simple little painting like this would take such a long time. All right, so as you can see, they definitely need a second coat, and if you try to do it while it's wet, you're going to put your paint. So we definitely got to let this dry and come back and do a second coat of yellow, orange, blue, green, and red, and then we will get to decorate them. So I may just do my second coat off camera to save some time. You can tell by looking at your own painting, do you need a second coat or not? So it is break time. All right, let's have some fun now. I got my little one hair brush out, and we're going to start adding some patterns to our cats. Our yellow cat, I'm gonna give him green ears. Just because I feel like it. And now you may have to take your little detail brush and go back in and maybe clean up some of the lines along the edges. Now if you have a steadier hand than I do, then you won't need to do that. But I can already see some spots that I'm going to need to do that on. Okay, so since he has green ears, maybe he's got a green tip on his tail, and maybe some little green stripes on his tail. Brushes don't hold a whole lot of paint. You have to keep dipping back in. may even have, some little green stripes coming from the edges. Burnt sienna that I squeezed out. And we're just going to give him some crazy streaks. Kind of like he's got some very little stripes going on in them. He's going to have patches of all different colors. Got a little bit of yellow on his ears. Tip of his tail. Little brushes. They're not like really polka dots, it's like a patch of color. Let's see what the orange will do on them. show too orange because of the blue. I'm not going to get my stroke. Yeah, don't be afraid to turn your paintings to make it easier to get the look that you want. This yellow over here to try and get some of our balance back. I'm not sure how great it's going to work on the red. I know that when you want to highlight red, you use yellow. Okay, what do we want to do with this one? What do we do with them? Let's give them some yellow ears. Decorate your kitty cats any way you want. Any way you want. Finished, other than once it dries, I'm going to go back with this little bitty brush and, you know, I'm going to clean up some edges like around the ears and maybe around the tail. The last thing to do besides cleaning that up, and you guys don't need to watch me do my cleanup, is to sign our name. And I'm just going to come in this little brick down here. Get any paint on the brush for it to write. I picked up my blue, a little bit of white. Okay. All done. Thank you.